I had written the screenplay to my Big Fat Greek Wedding, and I couldn't get it read because my agent dropped me. She told me I wasn't pretty enough to be a leading lady. And not fat enough to be a character actress. Like, she didn't say, you're not fat. Like, a character. She's like, you're not fat enough. Thank you.
Thank you. Major
Yeah, so I jumped up on stage and did the material as a one-person show. Yeah. And John Ratzenberger from Cheers came, right? Hello. And Rue McClanahan came. And I was so excited that she was in the audience.
There's a golden girl in the
audience. Totally. So cool. So her assistant came up to me after the show and she said, Rue would like to have you over for dinner. And I was like, okay. She said, can I have your number? And I was like, it's on the poster. That's the number you called for me to come over. It was our home phone number.
So, wow.
Yeah, because I'm not cool. So so we were driving there. My husband Ian is a New Yorker. Yeah. I'm from Canada. So I'm much more naive and understand. Like, I was like, I believe Rue McClanahan wants to have us over. We're driving there and Ian the New Yorker is like, why are we going there? I'm like, Rue McClanahan saw my show and she wants to have us over for dinner. So the assistant had called me and they wanted to do a whole Greek dinner and she had asked me for all these ingredients, everything. So we get there, the assistant opens the door. I can see like Rue and like Susan Rattan and people were out, Estelle Getty were out on the patio having drinks. And I was like, oh my God, I'm so excited to walk out there. And the assistant takes my arm, takes me to the kitchen and there's all these ingredients set out and she goes, okay, here's the Greek ingredients, start cooking.
That's a favorite story. It's so funny. What's so your husband's like?
My husband, I didn't even want to look at my husband because I could hear, feel his hot eyes boring into the side of my face. And I was like, all right. And opening up the phyllo pastry, like, first you butter it. I was just like, oh my God.
You're doing a demo.
Yeah. So I make the dinner, go out there, meet the people. They come in, they have dinner. Nobody's talking to us. It's just awkward and quiet. And we eat the dinner. And I'm like, this is weird. Ian's looking. So I finally thought we should go. So we stood up and we said, well, thank you for having us. I guess we're going to go. And I guess Rue McClanahan, I felt she must have sensed something was odd. Because as we walked to the door, she went, wait, 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 wait. Can you give Estelle Getty a ride home?
That's the best part of the story. So she gets in the back of your car?
No, she gets in the front seat. Estelle Getty's in the front seat. And I'm in the back just like, oh, my God. I don't even want to look at Ian. And she goes, she's like this. I don't get it. Are you a chef? She's saying to me in the back seat, and I was like, no, Estelle Getty, I'm an actor, and I have a Greek show, and you cook in it? She says. No.
The best thing is that you gave Estelle Getty a ride home.
The best.
That's my favorite story ever.